Hello friends, so let us continue with exercise number 2.2.
In that, number 13, we have 10 of half sine inverse 2x by 1 plus x square plus cos inverse 1 minus y square by 1 plus y square. Right?
So, I gave you two options. Either go with the substitution, or if you remember the theories,
if you remember that we have discussed two theories, that 2 10 inverse x can be written as sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square, and 2 10 inverse x can be written as cos inverse 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. So if I directly use these two equations over here, then it will become 10 of half. Instead of sine inverse 2x by 1 plus x square, I can write down 2 10 inverse x, and instead of cos inverse 1 minus y square by 1 plus y square, I can write down 2 10 inverse of y. Then 10 of 2 common and cancel, it will be 10 inverse x plus 10 inverse y. Now let's apply the equation, that it's 10 inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy, and now inverse function cancel, hence our answer is x minus y upon 1 plus xy. This will be the answer. It's already given to us that xy less than 1. Already given to us, also we have given mod x less than 1 and y greater than 0. These three conditions are already given to us. Okay, so as you just check, xy less than 1, so we can directly apply the equation over here. Okay, next question. Next question, we have number 15. In number 15, we have to find out y equals 10 sine inverse 3 by 5 plus cot inverse 3 by 2. This we have to find out. Now, as the first thing you need to keep in your mind, that if you have 10 outside and inside there is sine inverse and cot inverse, so convert sine and cos in terms of 10 inverse, so that we can apply the equation and then we can remove function and inverse. Okay, so first of all, let me take sine inverse 3 by 5 as theta. So sine theta will be equals to 3 by 5. Right? If sine theta equals to 3 by 5, then cos theta will be 1 by root 1 minus sine square theta, which is 1 minus 9 by 25. So we'll get cos theta as, I guess, 4 by 5 compulsory, right? Now, as you take sin theta as 3 by 5 and cos theta as 4 by 5, so what will be tan theta? Tan theta will be 3 by 4, right? So, tan theta will be 3 by 4. And also, if you take cot inverse 3 by 2 as 5, so cot 5 will be 3 by 2. So, from that, we can get tan 5 as 2 by 3. So, now this y will become what? Tan of, this will be theta plus phi, and then just apply the basic equation, tan theta plus tan phi upon 1 minus tan theta tan phi, and in that if I am going to put the values, so tan theta is 3 by 4 plus 2 by 3 upon 1 minus 3 by 4 and 2 by 3. So by solving this, we will get answer as 9 plus 8 is 17 upon 12 minus 6 6. So this will be your answer. Okay. So the similar kind of question they can ask based on, instead of 10, if they ask sine. So the same thing, but instead of getting an equation of 10, we'll get equation in form of sine theta plus 5. Right? Sine theta plus 5. So in that case, you have to find out sine theta cos theta, as well as from this 5, you have to find out sine phi and cos phi. Okay? Maybe they can do some kind of changes with that. Okay? Let's talk about next question. Okay, in the last session, we already completed number 16 and 17 also. 14, 16 and 17 we already completed in the last session, right? So, let's talk about that was number 18. So, here is number 15. 15 is 10 inverse x minus 1 by x plus 1 plus 10 inverse x minus 2 by x plus 2. Sorry, here it is x minus 1 by x minus 2 and x plus 1 by x plus 2, which is equals to pi by 4. So we have to find out value of x,
right? So this question is based on the solution. So first of all, what we'll do, we'll apply equation of tan inverse in the left side.
So it will be tan inverse of x minus 1 by x minus 2 plus x plus 1 by x plus 2 divided by x minus 1 by x minus 2 into x plus 1 by x plus 2, which is equals to pi by 4. Now if I take the LCM, so x minus 1 x plus 2 plus x plus 1 x minus 2 whole divided by x minus 2 x plus 2 minus x minus 1 x plus 1, we find that x minus 2 x plus 2 will be cancelled in numerator, both the denominators, right? And this tan inverse will be on the opposite side, that is 10 pi by 4. So now by multiplication brackets, x square minus x plus 2x, which is plus x minus 2, plus x square plus x minus 2x, which is minus x minus 2, whole divided by x square minus 4 minus x square plus 1 equals to 10 pi by 4, 1. So now just check, plus x minus x cancel, x square plus x square 2x square minus 2 minus 2 minus 4 by x square cancel, x minus 3 equals to 1. So now it will be 2x square minus 4 equals minus 3. Therefore, 2x square equals 1, and x square equals 1 by 2. So x will be plus or minus 1 by root 2. This is your answer. Right? So solution will be x equals plus or minus 1 by root 2. Now, one thing.
Okay, one thing I want to tell you that when you find this kind of question, mainly solution based questions in MCQs, right? So just do the cross verification. That means here we get two answers. We have get two answers, right? First x equals 1 by root 2 and second x equals minus 1 by root 2. So when such questions is there in MCQ, just put these two values one after another in the question to just verify whether LHS equals to RHS you get or not. Okay? Because in MCQs you find some questions where whatever number of solution you will get, those all solution maybe will not satisfy the condition. Okay? So just keep this point in your mind, but right now we are not going to do the cross verification because we know the answer that this is the correct one. Okay? Then, in next question, number 19, we have y equals cos inverse of cos 7 pi by 6. Okay? Now as we discussed this kind of sum in the last session, that if you want to remove cos inverse and cos, so 7 pi by 6 does not belong to the domain 0 to pi. Okay? So you have to convert it. So how do I convert it? So it will be 2 pi minus 5 pi by 6, I guess. Okay, just check. 2 pi minus 5 pi by 6. So 12 minus 5, 7 pi by 6. Now what is 2 pi minus? 2 pi minus will be in the fourth quadrant. In fourth quadrant, cos is positive. And conversion with pi will give you cos as it is. So now it will be cos inverse of cos 5 pi by 6. And we all know that 5 pi by 6 belongs to 0 to pi. So we can remove function and inverse. And the answer is 5 pi by 6. Okay, so this will be your answer. Next, number 20, we have y equals sine of pi by 3 minus sine inverse of minus half. Okay, so now it's sine inverse of pi by 3. Now, if you know the direct answer of sine inverse and minus half, then it's good. But if you don't, then first of all, let's keep minus sign outside. So plus sine inverse half. Then y equals sine of pi by 3 plus now sine inverse of half, that is pi by 6. So pi by 6 plus pi by 3, which is pi by 2. Hence we'll get y as 1. That will be your answer. Okay. Let's talk about the final question of the exercise. Okay. So in that, we have given y
equals tan inverse of root 3 minus cot inverse of minus root 3. Okay. So now, we'll keep tan inverse of root 3 as it is. Now, as we know that cot inverse of minus root 3 can be written as pi minus cot inverse of root 3. Okay. So, tan inverse root 3 minus pi plus cot inverse root 3. Now, we know that tan inverse root 3 plus cot inverse root 3. Tan inverse root 3 plus cot inverse root 3 is equals to what? Pi by 2. So, it's pi by 2 minus pi. Hence, y has answer minus pi by 2. Okay. So, this will be your answer. So, here is your end of the exercise number 2.2. Okay. But, let us discuss one of the point. Let us discuss one theoretical point. Maybe it will helpful to you to solve the MCQs. Right. The name of the note is interrelation. Okay. Interrelation. So, it is related with sine inverse x, cos inverse x and tan inverse x. So, let me tell you. The sine inverse x can directly write as cos inverse 1 by x, and the same thing you can directly write down in terms of tan inverse as x by root 1 minus x square. Okay? Then, cos inverse x can be written as sine inverse root 1 minus x square, and that is equals to tan inverse root 1 minus x square by x. Right? Same way, tan inverse x, if you want to write down in terms of sine inverse, so it will be sine inverse of x by root 1 plus x square, and that thing you can directly write down in terms of cos inverse as 1 by root 1 plus x square. All the conditions are 0 less x less 1, 0 less x less 1 and x greater than 0. These conditions are very much of important for you. Okay. Now let us discuss that how it is possible. So, I'll just take one example for sine inverse x. So, if I take sine inverse x as a theta, so what you consider as sine theta? Equals to x. Now let us check this condition in the triangle. Right. So, as we know that sine theta consider as opposite side by hypotenuse. So, this adjacent side will be what? 1 minus x square. Right? So, what if I want to write down for cos theta? Cos theta will be what? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. And now, if I want to find out theta, then it will be what? Cos inverse root 1 minus x square. Right? And similarly, what if I want to write down for tan theta? It's x by root 1 minus x square. So, hence theta will be what? Tan inverse x by root 1 minus x square. And now just check. This theta and this theta. These three thetas are equal to each other. So, we can say that sine inverse x equals cos inverse root 1 minus x square equals tan inverse x by root 1 minus x square. Okay? And MCQs also. Okay? So, in next session, we will discuss about the final exercise of this chapter. Thank you from my side.